Assalamu alaikum dear students, today we will take up apomixis. Apomixis, it has been derived from two Greek words. Apo means without and mixis means marriage. So it is the formation of new individuals by asexual methods which mimic sexual reproduction, including the seed formation, but do not involve fusion of gametes or sex cells. In other words, we can say apomixis is actually asexual reproduction. It is a method of asexual reproduction, but it mimics sexual reproduction in many ways, like producing seeds. Generally, we see in asexual reproduction, seeds are not produced. But here in apomixis, seeds are produced, but seeds are not produced by the fusion of gametes or sex cells. Because generally we see in sexual reproduction, seeds are produced, seed is the product of fusion of male and female gametes. But in apomixis, seeds are produced asexually. They are produced asexually. And the organism reproducing through apomixis are known as apomixis. And apomixis is controlled by genes. In apomixis, the new individuals are generally similar to the parent producing them, like other methods of asexual reproduction. And they are therefore clones of their parent, and it produces a uniform population of individuals. This uniform population of individuals is called clone, and each member of the clone is called a ramet. And like asexual reproduction, like other methods of asexual reproduction, this apomixis also produces clones. It also produces a uniform population of individuals, but the difference here is that it produces seed-like structures, which are like the seeds produced by sexual reproduction, but they have been produced asexually. Now this apomixis, it is of three types: agamospermy, parthenogenesis, and apogamy. Agamospermy. This agamospermy, it is a kind of apomixis in which embryo and seeds are formed without meiosis and syngamy. And embryo and seeds are produced without meiosis and syngamy. There is no gamete formation, that is, there is no meiosis, and there is no fusion of gametes, that is syngamy. The embryo commonly develops from a diploid nucellar cell or a megaspore mother cell. And either in agamospermy, either the embryo develops from a diploid megaspore mother cell, which we call as apospory, or it develops from a megaspore mother cell, that we call as either it develops from a diploid nucellar cell, it is called apospory, or it develops from a diploid megaspore mother cell, then it is called diplospory. That is, we can say agamospermy is of two types, that is apospory and diplospory. In diplospory, megaspore mother cell directly produce an embryo and a seed directly without undergoing meiosis and syngamy. And in apospory, a diploid nucellar cell, it directly acts as the embryo, it produces an embryo-like structure. Second type is that is parthenogenesis. It is a kind of apomixis in which embryos are formed from an unfertilized egg. Yani here, embryo is produced from an egg, but unfertilized, without fertilization by a male gamete, without fertilizing it by a male gamete. And it directly an egg cell, it produces an embryo. This process, where we produce an embryo from an egg, from an unfertilized egg, it is called parthenogenesis. And in parthenogenesis, the new individual formed may be haploid or diploid, depending upon the ploidy of the egg, that is the female gamete. Any the ploidy of the embryo, it depends upon the ploidy of the egg. If egg is diploid, then parthenogenetically produced embryo or the organism will also be diploid. And if it is haploid, the parthenogenetically produced organism plant, it will also be haploid. Number third type is apogamy. It is the formation of embryo or sporophyte directly from any cell of the embryo sac other than egg without fertilization. And if embryo is produced directly from any cell of the embryo sac other than egg without fertilization, it is called apogamy. The plants formed in this way are generally sterile because they are haploid. And the plants produced apo by this apogamous method of apomixis. This method of this apomixis, this type of apomixis, they are sterile because they are haploid. They are haploid. This is apomixis. Now, practical importance of apomixis. Apomixis was once regarded as an evolutionary deed, and because the meiotic segregation and recombination, that is meiosis and syngamy, on the female side are eliminated. However, now it is being regarded as the potential power, potential powerful genetic factor for use in crop improvement. Apomictically produced plants are genetically identical to the female plants. Therefore, if apomictics can be introduced in crop plants, it would provide an inexpensive way to perpetuate a given genophyte, preserving such characters as heterosis through successive seed generations. Apomixis would also simplify commercial hybrid seed production, as apomixis is not very common in major crop plants. Scientists are making serious attempts to introduce this trait into crop plants through selection and sexual hybridization with an apomictic relative. This is all about apomixis. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.